The urban population are increasing years by years. The urban cities are growing rapidly. This leads to the increase in the number of vehicles on road. If you see the data, it is estimated that by 2050, around 66% of the population will be residing in urban cities. And it will lead to more number of vehicles on road. So the challenges will be, it obviously leads to more congestion if there is no initiatives. So the congestions may further lead to economic loss, population, pollution, accidents, energy consumption. So how we are going to tackle this issue? It is estimated that if by standing in congested area, it may cost around 1 to 3% of country's GDP. And if you talk about road safety, then it is like 50 million people are at risk, and 1.3 billion people are meeting the accidents. So it's like every single second, two people's lives are at risk. So it is weird. And it is more weird if you look into the funding pattern of what's going over the years. The amount of money spent on R&D, ideas and innovations on car is much higher than what we have invested on traffic as well as intelligent transportation system. So we know the solution is using the public transportation system, which will curb all the issues that we are facing right now. But how do we improve the public transportation system? So in Qatar, the similar trend is going on. Whatever we have faced globally, the population have increased. The number of vehicles has increased drastically. High degree of travel patterns we are experiencing, and the number of vehicles are flooded on major corridors, so which will cause delay and increase the generalized cost of travel. So, and the third thing is the captive users versus the non-captive users. The captive users are those users which do not have the accessible to their private transport, so they have to fully rely on public transportation, and these people can be easily taken to public transportation if we improve the service reliability and quality of services, improving the comfort level. Whereas the non-captive users, they are stick to their private transportation because of the comfortability and the fuel efficiency of the private cars. And the issues apart, there are so many initiatives that are coming in Qatar. There is one such initiative is a Qatar Rail, which connects the different parts of the city, which makes the people to move faster. And when we talk of metro rail, there will be feeder services, there will be park and ride facilities. So how do we improve the ridership of this metro? That is a question. So in order to improve the ridership, we need to understand the customer, what customer wants really. We need to understand how the people make choices. So over a few years, over the last few years, the things have changed. And traditionally, the government or even the private sector, they started putting infrastructure, and the services will be laid on top of that, and people use the services. But over the last few years, the things are changing as the more sensors are in place, which gather a huge amount of data. And also we ourselves are generating a huge amount of data. So how to make best use of that? The data such as the where we move, how we use the transportation, and how we mobile. Earlier, the transportation concept was like a people moving from point A to point B. But now it has become more complex due to the different activities that are coming up. From point A to point B, in between we'll be dropping something, we'll be having groceries, we'll be moving somewhere else. So how to deal with these uncertain and complex situations? To overcome these traditional approaches, there are certain principles and way forward. The first thing, we need to gather all this information, all this data from different sources such as sensors, mobile data, internet data, GPS. And the second, we need to arrange all this data in a unified platform so as to make use of that data to predict in a realistic way. And third, to optimize the operations by analyzing the data as well as modeling the data in an accurate way. So the question comes, how we are going to make realistic predictions. In order to make realistic predictions and to improve the public transportation, we need to understand the people's choice. People make choice on different sets of rules, like if travel time is high and cost is high, whether I am going to use the public transportation or not. Similarly, if the cost is high and the comfort is very high, whether I will opt public transportation or not. So the traditional approaches that we are using right now is all the mathematical formulas which have been laid way back in 1950s, which do not have the capability to capture these uncertainties and the psychology of the users. So in such case, the data which we are getting from all different sources, which includes how we are going to use a particular mode or where we are going to travel, so this can be easily and realistically predicted using artificial intelligence. So some of the techniques that we can use to improve the prediction is the fuzzy logic as well as the artificial neural network, which is branch of artificial intelligence. So here is just a concept of the type of techniques I have used to model such situation. And the fuzzy logic, starting with the fuzzy logic. The fuzzy logic are generally created to capture the uncertainties. How the people create decisions is based on a simple phrase like if conditions, we can say. If X and Y are in place, then what will be the output? So if I say the travel time and travel distance is really high, then how it will impact the public transportation ridership. Similarly, artificial neural network, where it will train the data set again and again to perform much better. So by taking the advantage of the two models, we have created a hybrid model called neurofuzzing. This slide represents